Hey guys, Ultimate DJs here to talk to you about John Harrison. The auction is over, at least for now, and by all appearances, this was a very, very successful auction for Scopely. But now that some of you spent enough for a black market kidney, let's talk about why you did. Do you even know? Or are you a new player to the game wondering what everyone is talking about? Why everyone is scrambling about a two-year-old officer that's been shelved? And you're wondering what all the hubbub is about? Well, here we go. I'm going to teach you and show you how he works and why he may be worth it to some of you. First, let's take care of business. I need you guys to help me out and mash that subscribe button. Click the happy little like button and the bell too. That's good. Plus, you can leave your comments below and I'll do my best to answer your questions as we go along. So, John Harrison, let's talk about his function. Looking at his captain's maneuver, one can assume that this is based on base stats, and as most of these types of abilities typically are, which makes this maneuver so-so. But what people are willing to sell off at least two children for is John Harrison's officer ability. Let's take a look. At tier 1, he can ignore 60% of the shields for the first round of combat. So let's take a look. At tier 1, he can ignore 60% of the shields for the first round of combat. Now, some of you may hear people say, well, he's not as good since he was nerfed. Guys, this is the new ability after the nerf. He used to be even more stupid than this. This is still pretty daggone good. For example, he's so potent, this poor cat didn't even get a shot off in this screenshot. Some folks have been asking about the Hegda. Yes, it's a beast, and so is the Pylum, so is a Gladius, and yes, even a level 28 interceptor, the USS Saladin. Any ship that can deal significant amounts of damage in the first round is important with the officer John Harrison, as that's his duration, and you want to hit hard and fast. You want the highest possible damage with the highest possible crit hit chance, maybe a Gorkon, and the highest possible crit damage, maybe some Curla, or maybe Mud 2.0 with the chance to double all of your shots in the first round, or maybe Bones to increase his abilities, or Pike to increase the ability even more with the shield ignore. Look here, and again, level 50, bro. This Hegda fired only 3 shots in the first round. One was a critical, and the Sally never got a shot off, never once. And look at those numbers of shield versus hull. The shields didn't even have to fall because the hull was destroyed. And that's the key with Harris. He ignores the shields, he bypasses them. There's a lot to digest, so let's do some math. I want to start briefly with this control test. Here's the Sally with just Domitia, so no battle abilities that you can see. And let's pop over to the battle log. The reason I show you these tests is so we can establish a control, a baseline, and we know that out of the entire damage that you can issue, a percentage of this is mitigated, meaning it never lands on the ship. It's just gone, evaporated, never happened. Now, whatever is left over, that's the actual damage that lands, and it has a predetermined formula. 80% goes to shield, 20% goes to hull, always, unless an officer changes that, such as John Harrison. Another one is Borg Officer 1 of 10. He changes that ratio as well. But if the shield runs out, then it all goes to hull. If the hull runs out, then you're dead. So if we're looking at this screenshot, we can see the first shot we issued was 335,206 in damage. That's a pretty daggone good shot for a Sally. The hostile mitigated 191,621 of it, so it's gone. And that's pretty strong. It's a 57% of the shot that just vanished. That's the opponent's mitigation at 57%. Now, out of the remaining 143,585, 80% of that will go to the shield, 20% goes to the hull. That's 114,868 and 28,717 exactly, and you can see it in the battle log. The math checks. That's how it works. So let's add Harrison by himself and see what happens. Now, you can see here that I left Domitia on because I'm just wanting to test the officer ability at the moment. I did not want Harrison in the captain's chair, so I've put Harrison on the side card. Now, let's take a look at this battle log here in this screenshot and see what we dealt. Looks like 320,050 in actual damage dealt. The ship mitigated, or the enemy hostile mitigated, 182,957 and leaves us with 137,093 in actual damage. But we have Harrison, who is supposed to ignore 60% of the shield. Now, here's where we learn. Get your pens and paper ready, folks. What does this mean? What does it mean to ignore shield? How does the math work? You got to do a little bit of legwork to fully understand it. What you do is you start by calculating what normally would have been the shield damage, 80% of the leftover damage. So if our leftover damage is 137,093, we're going to take 80% of that and then take 60% of that away. So 60% of the 80% would be 65,804. Now, this is reduced from what the shield damage would have been, which was the 80% value, which was 109,674. So that's going to leave us shield damage of only 43,870, and voila! That's exactly what the log states. But what happens to the 65,804? It's added directly to the hull damage. So the hull damage was supposed to be 20% of the remaining leftover damage, which was 27,419. Now we're going to add the 65,804 for a total hull damage of 93,223 applied to the hull, which does, again, match the log. So let's look at this for a second. In terms of net yield, you are increasing your hull damage by roughly 340% from the original value. And applied in this one shot, it's an extra 66,000 damage to the hull of the enemy. And that's with one shot of the Sally. Let's add Bones to the captain's chair. Bones offers officers on the ship an extra 20% boost to their effectiveness. But here's what's key. Harrison is a set ability, meaning there's no proc rate. And what have we said before? If it's a proc rate, it's additive. If it's a set ability or an effectiveness ability, then it's multiplicative. So if we're going to boost Harrison by 20%, then we're going to use the following Scopely bonus formula, which is 60%, that's Harrison's ability, times parenthesis 1, which is his base value, plus the sum of bonuses. In this case, from Bones, we're going to get 20%. So that's 60% times 1.2. In this case, that's 72%. So now we can take the 60% shield ignore capability and boost that up to 72%. Here's a screenshot of that battle log, and we see that we dealt 364,001 in this shot. Mitigation was 208,082, so we toss it out the window, and that leaves us with damage of 155,919. That's what we're working with. 80% of shields would be 124,735. And 20% hull would be 31,184. Now, we have 72% effectiveness with Bones and Harrison. Let's take the shield value and ignore 72% of it. That's 89,809 taken from the shields and added to hull, making the new figures 34,926 to shield and a whopping 120,993 to hull, a net increase of 388%, and it matches the logs. But it doesn't stop there. We can increase our ability from Bones. We can get synergy from Sulu at 15%, giving a bonus of 35% to Harrison. So Harrison, still at tier one, folks, with a 35% bonus from Bones, is an 81% shield ignore, and the math checks out. You could utilize Pike and Moreau to get even more. Because of Moreau's synergy bonus, you can literally, with Pike, Moreau, and Harrison, ignore 100% of the shields in the first round and put the entire daggone load onto the hull. So how do you most effectively use him then? You need a ship with either A, a ton of shots in the first round, B, a huge shot in the first round, or C, a combo. Let's take a look at some of these ships. First, the USS Saladin, probably one of the best use ships for him because of that massively large gun that goes off in the first round. Sally only has two shots in the first round, and on my ship, they carry a potential of 111,198 before crits or attack bonuses or anything else. All research is added to this, but as far as comparison, this is a good spot to check. So cool, 111,000 base attack. Check, got it. Let's look at the Centurion. Two energy shots in the first round, but then four shots in each round following, so nope, because plus those two shots are weak sauce, at least on my ship, so I got two energies in the first round, so not a good fit. The Bordas looks good, two kinetics in the first round, but I don't have that ship, so I can't check the stats for the weapons, but with two kinetics and three total shots in the first round, that could actually be a good fit for Harrison. Let's take a look at the firing patterns for the rare ships. The Burrell, garbage. Intrepid, yeah, even worse garbage. Look at that firing pattern. The Gladius looks good, though. Okay, you got a couple of kinetics there, so that looks good. Let's take a look at the Enterprise. Yeah, no go there. The auger, you know, you get four shots with the auger, but they're all energy. And I really don't like it because look at this. These energy shots are from my auger. And man, those are weak. All right. At base, a max of 11,700 per shot. Even at four shots, that's only 60,000K base attack. The Sally is better in round one than the auger is in round one. The D4 is the winner of the epics with this officer because of the two kinetics in round one. The idea is to do the most damage in the first round as possible. Let's wrap up with this. Harrison is an absolutely great officer, but like all officers in the game, need to be complemented with the right bridge officers or the right team, if you will, on the ship. And of course, then the right ship. For those of you who sold your soul to the devil this past weekend and don't know why, I hope you have the tools to make Harrison a great functional officer for you. If you are single faction Romulan and only have a Centurion, then you made a very poor decision this weekend. But this officer, like any other, can be great if utilized properly. Do you have questions about how Harrison works or how the synergies and bonuses work, or just questions about crew in general? Leave them in the comments section below and I'll be happy to answer them. And of course, please be sure to subscribe to this channel. We appreciate it. We are getting so close to our goal. Please subscribe to the channel, click the little bell notifier, and like this video for more videos like this to come soon. My name is Ultimate DJs. This has been another teaching trek into John Harrison. I'll see you next time. Bye.